This is a GIS map of the 5 Mile House. And what I've done is I've taken our differential GPS instrument and I've located some fiduciary points on the UTM 16 North grid system. And what we'll do is we'll pull tape in between these points to lay out our geophysical grids. And so what I've done here is I've plotted these points so that I could work with my colleagues here to lay out nice square grids. So not everywhere on the property has a good view to the open sky, and so we have to arbitrarily put points on the grid where we've got good satellite geometry. As such, we'll use these intermediate points to pull tape at right angles to get a nice square grid.
Okay, so yeah, we're just trying to set up that original meterish grid upon which we will draw baselines shot in precisely with the GPS equipment so that sometime in the future people can come back to these same exact corners and know where this was, the survey was drawn from. We'll set up north-south, east-west baselines, mark it off in half meter increments, and that way as we run the GPR instrument back and forth, we'll be able to follow a straight line and know exactly where each signal is produced. We'll put a couple extra marks in the middle, and as you proceed, we'll see how Harvey runs the noggin unit on the smart cart.
This is a ground penetrating radar system.
We now, call is it that
GPR.
Steve, that's on our line, right?
Ground penetrating radar. And this okay. system is set up today to record 500 megahertz.
No, it's not 47
data.
Meters, that's 47.
So essentially, we're working off a reflection technique where we're transmitting electromagnetic energy down into the subsurface, ultra high frequency radar energy. And when it encounters something reflective in that frequency band, the receiver will pick up the signal, a digital signal is created, and as we move along a profile, we can create sort of a slice into the subsurface, a reflective, layered picture of what the subsurface looks like. If we encounter archaeological objects or graves or grave shafts, then those assumption is those objects will be reflective in the radar spectrum, and so we can create a series of 2D slices, interpolate those into a grid, and have a three-dimensional scan of the subsurface if everything works right.
Well, the main thing would be finding areas that have possible features that we could then in subsequent years come in and do some archaeology, and you know, maybe find a building foundation or a cellar or a well or something like that. So this is, hopefully we'll map out the area here so that it'll give us some idea of the features that are here. There was a legend that there were 3 burials here, and we have reason to believe that there are 3 over here, but hopefully the GPR will confirm that.